was appointed at Eton College. This is the first Hindu appointed at Eton College as a lecturer. I was wondering, because when a Muslim cleric was appointed at Eton, next day headline news in every newspaper was Muslim Imam at Eton College. I said, wow, they give so much respect. Of course, they said, oh, this is important. And when they appointed me after a few years as the first Hindu tutor at Eton, I was saying, okay, let me look at the headlines.
Zero.
And then I asked one journalist I know, I said, why is no mention? I'm not saying I want to be proud, but at least there should be some mention to be. They said, Mr. Lakhani, do you throw bombs? I said, we don't throw bombs. That is why, she said. The reason is you have to be robust to be recognized. See, you must show strength to be recognized and given an opportunity to be equated to the rest of the world. If you are weak, you'll be cast aside. That is what is happening. So it is our weakness, in fact, that in a way allows us to be kind of pushed, shown in a very poor light. We are not robust. I don't say we throw bombs. The bombs we throw are much more stronger than the physical bombs you hear about. The bombs we possess are potent ideas which no other religion has got. And these ideas are something like far more powerful, potent than any of the physical bombs. And we possess them, but we don't even recognize them. Forget about, chucking it in the system. We don't even know that we have this. So if you like, this poor idea of how Hinduism comes across in the media is, in a way, blame yourself, blame ourselves. Learn, be robust. I'm not saying throw bombs. Throw bombs which are potent ideas, you will win. I'll give you another funny example, how potent our ideas are. Once I was invited by certain grammar school to do a session where we had a Muslim speaker, a Muslim imam, a Jewish rabbi, a Christian minister, priest, and myself as four people, and this was called question time at certain grammar school. There were 15 and 16 year old youngsters, 100 of them sitting across, and they said, okay, now you can challenge the people of religions regarding any question you have. It's a very interesting session. I show you how we stand up. Provided you throw these potent ideas, you win. I just show you the example. The boys at certain grammar school are very sharp cookies. So the first question that arose, very interesting, you'll smile. They told, we want to ask the panel, what will happen to Mr. Lakhani when he dies? Now you can't be more cut, cutting in your question. And of course, all the three other Abrahamic tradition people became pink in the face, red in the face. And they had to answer the question. They didn't ask me, they asked the other three. So one by one, they came up to the mic, and first one said, I don't know what will happen to Mr. Lakhani, only God knows. And all of them repeated the same thing with slight variation, that we can't tell you, because if they say Mr. Lakhani is going to hell, they'll be booed by these young people. Why should Mr. Lakhani be sent to hell? Such a lovely chap with the orange jacket. Why should he be sent to hell? So they can't do that, they'll be booed off the stage. So the one by one, they came and said, we don't know, God alone knows. But do you think the boys are going to let them off? The second boy stood up. He said, in that case, if only God knows, we want to ask you, what does your scripture say will happen to Mr. Lakhani? That's the second call, port of call, your scriptures. And of course, they're again pink in the face. Well, how can they reply? So none of them stood up. And then you see, this is I'm just showing the potency of our tradition. It's highly majestic. I said, look, we are telling the people of other tradition, you are not going to hell. In fact, there is no eternal at all. So in the first state, the youngsters started to applaud me. In the way, this is the potency of our ideas we possess. So please recognize the potency of our tradition, present it in a very rational, sensible format without actually being physical about it, and you will win hearts and minds throughout the world. This is my personal experience.